We're also focusing on in the upper atmosphere what may be helping to steer Ada. It looks like an upper ridge is developing off the east coast. That is going to start pushing the storm more into the Gulf. Then as we get into the early to middle part of next week, Ada is in the eastern Gulf. What we start to see developing is a big upper ridge over the southwestern Gulf and an upper trough across the central U.S. These two features should act in such a way that it will keep pushing Ada away and keep the storm in the eastern Gulf. And that is exactly what the models are doing right now. Question as to how close it's able to get to the Louisiana coastline, but right now the models are saying it is not coming to southeast Louisiana. As a matter of fact, looking at satellite, can you find Ada? It's a struggle. It is in a struggling environment right now. This is where the Hurricane Center is saying the low-level center is. Not really showing up, at least on satellite, because there's a lot of cloud cover. But when you colorize the satellite, there's certainly no thunderstorms developing around the center of the storm. So we will see how the structure of this storm is able to develop overnight and into the start of the weekend. Hurricane Center is saying it will begin to strengthen to a tropical storm as it approaches Cuba. And then again, making that turn may already be over Florida by the end of the weekend and start of next week, or it may stay in kind of the Straits of Florida as it meanders into the Gulf. And then here is that little turn, because as we get into the middle of next week, we are expecting the upper atmosphere to favor more of it staying in the eastern Gulf. All of the models are in a far better agreement with there's that turn and then the eventual turn more toward the north. And as I mentioned, we like to see consistency in the models from run to run, and that has certainly been the case with Ada. What structure is Ada going to be? Well, the GFS is not really initializing well because it has it as a fairly well-organized system, and it's not. So the hurricane or the official forecast is saying a tropical storm, whereas the GFS is indicating more of a hurricane by this point in South Florida. We will see, but notice, as it gets into the Gulf, we start to see the storm weakening. That upper atmosphere, the upper energy from the upper ridge and trough will also be introducing wind shear and dry air, which will also help to weaken the storm as it eventually kind of almost dissipates as what is left of it starts moving inland, possibly by Thursday. It'll be something to watch, but right now it is not a threat to us.